to the Gun Collective, everybody. My name is Murphy Brown. Today we're going to look at a firearm from CZ USA, the 805 Bren. But first, let's hear from our sponsors.
The RE Factor Tactical Operator Band is the ultimate in discreet survival tools. Offered in a variety of colors, the Operator Band houses almost 10 different survival implements to get you operating operationally in no time. Get 10% off your entire order at refactortactical.com using the code TGC10.
Now that all the hipsters out there are hot and bothered because it's a CZ video, they have turned up their volume and slid their chairs forward. Let's get into the CZ Bren 805. All right, in all honesty, I appreciate a Czech gun just as much as the next guy, and the 805 Bren wasn't any different. It's a great firearm. The one that you'll see in this video is a pistol version with an SB tactical folding brace, 11-inch barrel, 1-in-7 twist. 5.56223 was its chambering. I ran steel case, brass case, all different grain weights through it, and it ran flawlessly. I really like the pistol version of this. It's very compact with that SB tactical folding brace. The shorter barrel takes a little bit of weight out of this gun. And yes, this gun is heavy. That is always a point of contention when people are talking about the 805 Bren. The Bren does use a short stroke gas piston system. This is where a lot of that weight comes from. Unloaded with no optic, the pistol is gonna weigh in just under 7 pounds. If you go with the carbine version with a 16-inch barrel, you're looking at 8 pounds right out of the box. So it is a hefty gun. This gun does have a reciprocating charging handle, which is not a plus in my mind. In this day and age, I don't understand why we still have charging handles that move back and forth. It just seems like it's an easy fix. As long as I knew that it was reciprocating and where it was pretty easy to avoid on the Bren. Also, I can move it from the left to the right side. Whatever my preference was, I kept it on the left. Again, I would just prefer not to have it at all. Hopefully that can be corrected in the future. Magazines for the Bren, good news here. You can use any AR-15 magazine you want. A lot of times when we're talking about European guns, there's a strong chance that you're gonna get some weird, wonky proprietary mag with the firearm. Not in this case. Use any of the stockpiled AR-15 magazines you might have at your home. The Bren does have last round hold open, but it doesn't have a bolt catch to send the bolt into battery. You have to tug on the charging handle, which allows the bolt to go forward, chambering another round. Not a huge issue, just something you gotta train around if you're gonna use the Bren on the regular. Accuracy on the Bren was good enough for government work. I got out to about 225 yards with the Bren. Hit with regularity on a steel silhouette from TA targets. For a standard issue military gun, I'm not expecting a lot. I don't think it's gonna shoot dime size groups. I haven't grouped it yet, but it was good enough to hit targets out past 200 yards. And I think that's a realistic expectation out of this gun. Moving down, the safety was ambidextrous, a little stiff, but I liked it. It was pretty intuitive, pretty easy to get to with my thumb. I also could do the old knuckle swipe on the right-hand side of the firearm if I needed to. Again, just a little bit stiff, and maybe over time that will work in. Trigger out of the box was actually pretty impressive. I wasn't expecting a lot. Again, this is a military standard issue firearm. You think you're gonna get a pretty mil-spec trigger, nothing to write home about. But this trigger was actually pretty good. Pretty light, audible crisp reset. Not a lot to improve on, to be honest with you, with the trigger. Pistol grip on the Bren was okay. You can change out the back straps to whatever your preference might be, but honestly, my preference would be that I could just add any AR-15 grip that I want to it. All right, getting down to brass tacks, the MSRP on the Bren is $19.99, which is a little salty when we're talking about modern sporting rifles. In this day and age, when you can get an AR-15 for 500 bucks, that's a pretty steep price tag. But the FNH SCAR 16, which is often compared to the Bren, is about $1,000 more than that. So I think you're getting a better gun with the Bren, and you're gonna save $1,000, which is a win-win in my mind. Like I said in the beginning of the video, I think the Bren 805 is a solid gun. There's some stuff to be improved on, but that leaves opportunity for other manufacturers to make parts and pieces to add on to this weapons platform. Starting with the rail, that would be one area which could use some improvement. The current one's a little big, chunky, it's not M-lock. Just something that could be streamlined a little bit. If you guys have any thoughts on the 805 brand, of course, leave them down below in the comments. I want to hear from you guys. Thank you for watching the Gun Collective. We appreciate all that support. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. My name is Murphy Brown. We'll see you on the next one.